So that'd turn our awning back, our awning light on. The next one down is dimmable lights. So you've got dimmables at the front, and you've got a dimmable up there as well. So once you've turned them on, it'll say dimmer level there. Then you can just, the middle button is select. So if you want to get into anything, they're up and down arrows and that select. So you press select and they'll go as bright as 100. Or they'll go as low as 5. So you're having a nice romantic meal.
Oh, it's okay.
Yeah. You can get them down. See it.
All right, when I've charged it, we can hide it.
And then that next one down is the rest of the lights.
The lights.
And then they're all, every one of them's individually switched yet. As well, every light you'll find a switch for every light, and all your spot lamps are dimmable as well by that thing on the back.
Yeah.
The next one down is the water pump. So to turn it on, because the water pump's on board, to turn it on, just press that button. Once you see the LED, your water pump's on.
Okay.
Yeah. So then you can start priming your system up. Then once you put your drain down, turn your water, get your lights on, get your water pump on, and then just start with this. You don't, like your other one, you had to make sure you had water in before you could turn anything on.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
On this, you don't need to worry because it won't kick in until it's got water in it.
Right.
So until you've primed, you can have it switched on, but until you put water in that tank, prime your system up, it won't attempt to ignite use the electric element.
The Truma,
the old one.
Make that mistake, but
as soon as you turn it on, they start heating up, don't they? Because it's just like boiling a kettle with no water. Whereas these new combi ones now, until you prime the system, they won't kick in. Okay. So when you're seeing then it with the screen had gone dull, if you wave your hand in front of it, it's got a sensor there, it'll wake the screen up for you. So we'll talk about your options on your next side. So we'll get it back to the start. So that's the up and down arrows to select through what you want. And then the middle one's the select. So up and down to scroll through. And then middle is to select that particular feature. So the leisure charging, that's just letting us know that what condition the leisure battery's in and that it's charging. Next one down is vehicle battery. So as soon as you plug the car in, if you come inside, that'll tell you the condition of your vehicle battery. Solar panel, so that'll just let you know how much energy you're drawing from your solar panel, because it's inside, it won't do anything. Yeah. If it's hot, you've got it outside in the hot sun, you'll see it'll read quite high what it'll give you. Select battery, so you can change from your leisure battery to your vehicle battery, but with having a solar panel, you shouldn't need to.
Okay.
AC limit, so what you can do is you press the select, you can go from 5 amps all the way up to 16 amp limit. So as you'll know, some pitches you get 16 amps, farmers field type ones you get
maybe 10 amp or 6 amp
limit. So if you set a 16 amp limit, what the van will do, if you flip the kettle on, the van will shut the heating and hot water system down, it'll stop putting any power to that, and then as soon as the kettle's finished boiling, that'll kick back in. So the van will try and limit the power usage,
so you don't have to be working it out yourselves all the time.
But it's not foolproof. You go and stick the microwave on, then flip the kettle on, and then put the air dryer on. You're still going to pop. But if you're sensible and if you don't try and overload it, this should stop any unnecessary tripping. Like if you put the toaster on for 2-3 minutes, the heating and water will go off. Soon as the toaster clicks off and stops drawing power, it'll let power go back to that, and then your heating and stuff will kick back in then. So it is quite good, or you can just leave it off, and then it won't do anything then.
It's up to us.
So if the farmer starts shouting, it's your own fault. So internal temperature, so that's what temperature's inside the van.
Mm-hmm.
If we press select, it'll tell us how humid it is inside the van. If we press select again, it'll tell us the temperature outside, and then it's just back to internal temperature on that. Yeah. So you just press, you can
scroll through them.
Scroll through on the select button, yeah. Then we press down, then we're down to dimmable lights again, so then we could just press select and then get them brighter. Heater settings, Are you interested in the Swift Command on your phone?
I've downloaded it and I've registered, so...
Are you going to use it?
I've got no idea.
I can give you a quick brief. I can't make you an expert, but right. I can show you the basics on the app.
Okay.
I can, at the end, I'll run through that with
right.
you.
Right, okay.
So, if we're going to be using the app, what this is what we need, heater settings. So we'd scroll down, we'd press select, then it'll come up, control, manual. We want change it to app, yeah, then it knows right. it's getting its commands from the third party.
Okay.
Then. Okay. Right. And then, but we'll leave it in manual because obviously we're going to be playing a bit in it. And then you just press down to see exit settings, come back out of it. So the main one that you might need to go into would be system settings. So that would be to set the time, the minutes, the day, the date, the month, the year. Key beep, if you want it to beep every time you press a button, like it is now. Backlight, how long this will stay lit for.
Yeah.
LEDs, so how long these LEDs will stay illuminated for. Tank alarms. Now, if you change your battery, you might see it saying water problem. Water tank low, water level low, sorry, should I say. So you haven't got an onboard tank, but what Swift do is they put this same unit from the top range motorhomes the way down. So it's, if you change your battery, it'll start saying water level low. So you've come to system settings, scroll down until you find tank alarms, and then just simply press select so it's off and it will rectify it. Yeah, it'll rectify that problem. Then Bluetooth pair. So are you on Android or are you on Apple?
Android.
So Bluetooth pair. What we'd need to do before to pair your phone up, before you open the app, you have to pair it Bluetooth. So you'd open your Bluetooth settings, you'd click select on there, you'd pair the Bluetooth up, and then you'd open your app and start going that way.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
It's nice and simple, don't worry. So all you got to remember is,
We're twice his age, yeah. So it's so much more difficult for us.
It don't work. Honestly, it's one of them things, it will come in time, don't worry. Honestly, I couldn't get to grips with it when I first started. I was like, what's this? But no, it's honestly, it's all you got to do. Once your phone's Bluetooth paired, though, it's paired then. You shouldn't be needing to repair your phone.
Right. Will it just work with one phone, or can it work with...
You can pair more. You can pair up to four phones, right. But you can only use one at a time.
Right.
So if you activate your phone and then you set all the van up on mm-hmm. your phone,
can't then use
you can't
phone
go on
too.
His phone and then start changing it all again.
Right.
You'd have
right.
to set it. You'd have to take right. your phone off, put it back on manual, then put it on app, then right. open
pair
your
it, pair it with the other phone.
Then,
yeah.
Well, you can have them both paired so that this knows it's got two phones.
Uh-huh.
But you'd have to come out of it on your phone. And then go into
yeah,
you'd have to
so that it logs with that phone.
Yeah, so then it right. knows it's getting its because right. you won't let you confuse the system, because you could be like you could be in Asda doing shopping and you could be having a pub while he's shopping, having a quick pint,
yeah,
and both be arguing over how what it's going to be, so they won't let it.
Yes, so. I mean, there's a side of me can't quite get my head around whether or not we would. Really use it, or if we would just do what
you know,
we've done in the past.
It's like hive eating in your house. If you're really into your gadgets,
yeah.
you're going to use it. It's one of them, it's you find it's the real technophobes that being work going, oh, I'm going to warm my house up, and then you get so what, I'll warm my house up.
So what,
my
does it automatically. Yeah.
Mine's on a thermostat, don't yes. worry, my house will be warm.
But if the heating's on, you can program it.
You can, yeah. So if you're both in the pub having a nice meal, and you think, I think I'll warm the van up, I'll get the lights on ready for when I get home, just open the app, because this has a SIM card in, so as long as you've got an internet signal on your phone,
yeah,
then you can talk to this wherever you are.
Right.
Okay. But you can program it separately from the app,
yeah.
In any case,
the app will work when you're in the van on Bluetooth, and when you're miles away, you can use an internet signal to communicate with it, so.
Or if you're miles away, I can fiddle with this and upset it all.
Yeah, quite.
Yes. Yes.
And then if you wanted to delete the paired devices, so if you change your phone, you just into Bluetooth delete, then you'd go back up to Bluetooth pair and then pair your new phone
yeah.
up. Yeah.
Yeah.
Exit settings. So
that sounds a
exit settings. So there is an engineer's mode on this. I'm not gonna tell you how to get in it, like, because
no.
you can really upset the van. But if you ever get into anything and you think what have I got in? Just look for that. Keep pressing that.
Until and it'll come back eventually.
Yeah, until you see that and then just go bam, get back out of it. Because you do get people that will try and mess with everything on the van and really upset the van. Yeah. And then it's a nightmare then, because then they've got to bring the van back to us while our engineer sorts it out.
Yeah.
So, if you're getting anything...
We'll try not to do that. It's a 235-mile in one direction for us.
Exactly. So it's a 470-mile round trip.
Come a long way to collect a caravan.
And then the other menu is just Sergeant E620. That's just telling you what system this is. So if you're on the phone to an engineer, he might say, what system? And then you just...
So that's what it is.
That's what he's telling you.
Okay.
Okay.
So you got any more questions about that one?
Not at the minute.
Fairly straightforward. Once it's set up, once you've got your battery on it and you've set your time and your date, the tank alarm thing won't happen because your battery stays on. So it's only if you take the battery off and it resets it back to standard, then it'll start beeping. And
so maybe it's when we put our battery in, we'll set your battery up in its initial whatever, so that we're ready to...
Yeah, and then all you have to do then when you come in is you get in the van, you press that, and then you just go, one light, water pump, and that's that panel.
Right, so done. Press at that side.
The bottom,
on, the bottom, and bang, then bang, all bang. Of those, and that's it. You've got the basics all done.
And then that is that from that panel.
Yeah,
then.
Right.
So like that L there is letting us know we're on leisure battery.
Yeah.
If the solar panel was doing anything, you'll get like a little circle sun.
All right. Yes.
It's on flash away, letting you know that your solar panel is doing something.
Yeah.
And that's just letting you know your mains electric.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. Yep. So next side, I'll just turn it off.
Old time.
Alright.
We can change it.
It's because obviously I had no battery on when it came in here, then I've put a battery in, so it's just the factory settings at the minute. So it's when I put your battery in, I'll come in and I'll set the correct time and date and everything for you. So this side, this is the heating now, the hot water and the heating. So that one press of the button, as soon as you get a green light, then you know it's coming on. So, that menu screen there, that's just letting you know that you've got the heating is on.
Right.
That's letting you know what it reckons the internal temperature is. So you might notice a difference between them and them. But one sensor could be down there, and the sensors are in different places, or one might be in there, I think.
Right.
But the sensors are in different places in the van. But you can offset this to read the same as that if you wanted to. Not a lot of people, probably not bothered, actually. Yeah.
We'll get it to a level that's
We'll have it set to what we have.
The main one you don't want to worry about the temperature that's telling you. The one you want to worry about is that, because that temperature on there is what will thermostatically control the heating. So that is the main temperature to worry about what this one's telling you.
Yeah, so get it to what you find comfortable.
Yeah.
Yeah. But,
that's letting you know you're in the mains electric.
Mains.
That's just letting you know what the temperature is. So, press the menu button, and what we get is that. So, that there is the thermostat for the van. So, that's what temperature the heating is. So, it will go from 5 up to about 30. Yeah. So
don't knock it down too far.
Like I say, you can change all this anyway. And then this next one is hot water. So...
Oh, right.
That is there, is hot water off.
Right.
Half a bar and green is hot water on.
Right.
Yeah, so that's just now giving you hot water.
Uh-huh.
Hot water boost. So that'll turn the heating off and focus all the energy on heating the hot water up. It'll do either 2 cycles or 30 minutes. Whichever comes first, then it'll send itself back. But what you'll probably find, after 1 cycle, it will be hot. So you just come back, press it back, and then it'll let the heating kick back in then. Just put it back.
So if you have it on that, where you've got half a bar...
Half a bar, that will give you... It'll heat the hot water to the same temperature anyway.
Yeah.
But that's just hot water on, and then you'll get heating as well.
Yeah.
If you put it on boost mode, it'll turn the heating off to concentrate all its power on getting your hot water as fast as it can.
So if you were wanting showers or something
use all the hot water in the shower... While the next person's waiting, you just flick it on boost, and then it'll half the time, and then the next person can get a shower, and then you just flick it back. So the next one down is the power now, what energy source we're using. So that one's the electric. So that's now off. So one press is roughly 1 kilowatt of electric, roughly 2 kilowatts of electric, roughly 3 kilowatts of electric. So that will power your heating and hot water off 3 kilowatts of electric. The next one down is gas. Right, it's a combi boiler. It can be run on both. So you can have 3 kilowatts and gas. So when the grass is green, it's on. So that's 3 kilowatts of electric and gas now powering your hot water and your heating.
Wow.
So it's a lot of power goes in. With an Audi system, it is basically the whole outside of your van is a radiator. It runs the heat around the whole of the outside of it. You will never be cold. You can go and use this right in the middle of December, start of January, and you will not be cold inside your van.
That's the intention.
Yeah, honestly, yeah. I promise you, you will not be cold. I'd be surprised if you'd be opening windows before you turn.
Gordon would be.
Yeah. So if we've got it on 3 kilowatts,
and
we decide to put the kettle on,
if you've got your amp limit here,
yes,
it'll knock that off.
It'll knock that one down.
It'll take that 3 kilowatts. It'll cancel that,
right?
And then it'll let you have your kettle then.
Right.
So it would be useful to have the limit running if you use the van in the middle of the winter.
Yeah.
Because then, if you're going to be charging 3 kilowatts of electric, it's a lot of electric. It's a lot to have spare. So if the van knows that it can use that 3 kilowatts elsewhere, it really does minimise the chance of a pop post.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, gas as well. You can just run it on gas on its own.
Mm-hmm.
So you can just run the system on gas on its own, and a lot of people, it will work fine on 1 kilowatt. It will do everything off 1 kilowatt, it'll just take longer.
800 watts or something like
that? Yeah, so it will work perfectly fine off 1 kilowatt if need be, but it will just take longer. Everything will take longer.
Yes. Yeah.
So if you go out in the middle of January and it looks like it's going to snow, my personal option would be to be getting it on gas and 3 kilowatts. And
then initially.
And then get everything up to temperature and then just maybe knock the gas off and leave it on 3 kilowatts of electric because you've already paid for that. Because you pay for that with your pitch, don't you?
Absolutely.
Yeah. I'd be just getting it there on the gas and then I'd be looking at probably shutting the gas off myself. So next is this little corner here, the cog, is the settings. So in settings we've got a night timer, so if you like it colder in the night, you can set a timer so it automatically drops it down to a certain temperature at night. If you like it hotter in the day, so you could have one, for example, you could have one running at 18 through the night, and then you could have it on day mode where it'll run at 20 degrees. Say you could set it at 20, 21 degrees, so it will automatically at 9 o'clock in the morning, it will automatically start pumping up to 21 degrees, and come 10 o'clock at night, or whatever time you set, it'll start automatically drop it down to 18 degrees then. So the next one is the prioritise. So when you initially turn it on, it's what source it looks to run off. So it will initially look to prioritise to run off electric over gas. Or you can set it to try and use gas before it uses electric.
Okay. Right. Yep.
So it's probably best you just leave it on electric, because then as soon as you plug into the post, it'll run then straight off the mains, because that's what power source it'll look for first. If it can't get electric, then it'll try gas on its own. If it can't get that, then it'll tell you like heat or failure. That's because you've not got no electric, or you've got no gas.
Yeah, you haven't plugged anything in.
Yeah. Next one is just how bright the screen is and how long it stays.
Right. Yep.
Grey means it's a feature not available, so we don't worry about it.
Right.
Next one is the time and date of this, so what time it is and what day it is. The next one down is the little Pac-Man symbol, which is an anti-microbiological killer. Big word here, but basically what happens is if you've got that switched on while you're using the van, about 2-3 o'clock in the morning, it will heat the hot water tank up as hot as to its top temperature to kill any bugs and bacteria that are in the water. So when you wake up in the morning, your hot water tank is sterile.
Right.
So any hot water that you draw first thing in the morning will be sterile.
Yeah.
So that's an on-off button, is it?
Yeah, so it's green, it's on.
Right.
So then you don't need to do anything else, it will just automatically do it during the night. It'll just heat your tank up. and away it goes.
That's you. Keep warm.
And then the next one is temperature offset, like I was saying. So if you want both to read the same, you can either add degrees to this one or take. So if say that one was 14.5 and that one was 15, you could minus half a degree, so that'll say 14.5 like that one does. Some people like that, some people aren't bothered.
I guess we'll probably not do that first.
Next one is mountaineering. So if you ever go above 1,000 meters sea level, you put high altitude mode on, it will draw extra air into the van to give you more oxygen. It will just it'll draw air in for you.
Okay. And we've got the Alps.
Beep is whether you want it to beep or not every time you press a button. That one is a once a week timer. So say if you had it outside your house, you had water in the tank, and you had it plugged into the mains electric, you could set that timer, it will come on, heat the van up, heat all the hot water up, and then after its 24-hour cycle, it will just shut itself back down. So you could just like run the heat in, you know, if it was outside your house and you had the power in, left water in, you could just run the heat in once a week, and it was, you know, keep warm the van up for you. Now the next one, that's your thermostat. So like it's thermostatically controlled, you can turn it to constant or thermostat, but if you want to know how a boiler bag rice feels when it's in the pan, turn your thermostat off, because you'll get to 30 degrees and it will stay there. It will just keep going all day long at 30 degrees until one of you falls out the van, can't breathe. So yeah, I'd leave the thermostat definitely on. On thermostat mode. And then next one is good old reset. So if it won't do what it's told,
reset the button.
Reset, like anything external. So before Swift come along with the Swift command, Aldi have set it so that you can download an app on your phone through Aldi to communicate with your Aldi heating system, but you don't need to, because you've got Swift command. That will give it its orders. Language, if you fancy talking Italian.
No thanks.
Service, so if there's any faults with your heating, phone up for advice. The engineer might say, press service and tell me what codes come up. Yep. Installed accessories is what we need to worry about. So if you decide you're going to start using your phone, you need to put this on app, like I showed you, and then tick third party panel, and then they both know that they're going to be getting the commands from a third party source. Right. So that then knows that that this is going to be telling that what to do, and that knows that you're going to be telling that what to do from your phone. So it just syncs everything up. But if you're not going to be using it, you don't particularly need to, just need to. So if you start messing with your phone and you think, why is my eating not coming on, just check you've got third party ticks.
Yeah, that you've pressed the right button.
Yeah, and then that's it on that one.
Right, okay.
So any questions?
Not yet, no.
Not yet, that's right. Not yet.
Halfway
presumably
through.
There's a... It's all in the...
Everything is in the manual. This will be uploaded onto YouTube by tomorrow, so you'll be able to watch that. But as long as you can turn your lights on, your power on, and your water, and you know how to get hot water and a bit of heat, I'm
we
happy.
Be okay.
As long as you can turn them on, and all you got to do is turn that on, press menu, and then it's just up and down, up and down, up and down. So it
just concentrate on that basic on, to start
on,
with.
On. And then everything's on then.
Right. You just knock it back to 2 kilowatts.
So
okay.
Basically all you want to do is get to site, get everything switched on, then get into there, system settings, get your AC limit on, and then that's it. Then you don't need to. So all you're going to need to do then is come and turn your heating up and down. Yeah, and maybe turn your gas off and on for your heating.
Possible settings for overnight.
Possibly, It's one of them, you can either set it by timer, or as you're putting the bed out, you can just
knock it down.
And then if you just knock it down...
If it's that simple,
you just press that button. If you've got it set, so if you've got it there at 22, say, then all you do is just come up to it, stick it at 18, or whatever you like, through the night.
Yeah.
And then the thermostat will just keep the van at 18 degrees all night long anyway.
Yeah.
So it's up to you. If you want to be using technology, if you want to get right into the technology side, then start using timers and stuff. But if you just want a nice, easy life, then just straightforward.
Right. Yeah, yeah.
Like I am. Yeah. Missus is always, so how do I do this? Don't bother. Just turn it
just
down.
Just do it easy,
yeah, just turn it down when you're too hot.
Yeah.
Okie doke.
Yeah, we can cope with that.
So that is as, it really is as complicated as that gets, honestly.
Yeah.
But it's amazing, the technology.
The technology behind it is so advanced, but using it is, people think it's a lot more scary when I'm saying, I'll show you, and you're thinking, oh, but then when I start showing you, you think, well, it's not too bad, really.
That's quite it's nothing reasonably intuitive.
It's one of them, with your 12-year-old system, you would have had a separate one for your heater, so you would have had an electric thing for your heater, then you would have had one for the gas on the heater, then you would have had a gas heater, and then you would have had an electric heater.
Yeah.
So if you think
quite a lot of complex things.
Four controls to do one thing, whereas now you press
a few buttons.
Press a couple of buttons and everything's done. I mean, it just makes life so much easier.
Yeah.
It's just
No knobs or buttons.
That's just it, thinking, right, have I got the gas on or am I electric, looking around thinking, where's that switch gone? Because my auntie's got an old Bailey, you see, when she had, and that's how her Bailey was. So she had the electric thermostat for it was there where the plugs are, so you could change it like between 500,000, 2,000
kilowatts. Yeah, I was around the size of the wardrobe. Mm-hmm.
For the heating. Then you had on the top of the fire,
the
gas control,
and
then the heating. The electric was near the door, so you could like heat the hot water up off the electric, and then the gas one was right down by the boiler, so you was like scratching your head when you got in it. But she's got a newer Bailey now, which has got the Truma system in, which is similar to the Aldi, which isn't too bad.
Right.
Oh, I used to hate it when I used to borrow a road on. What have I done here? So,
okay,
the bed. Should we start with the bed, and then we'll work backwards?
I'm assuming it's fairly straightforward.
Well,
there we go.
You be the judge.
That's easy. Yeah.
Same as the other one.
Yeah. Same as the other
one. All I'd say is turn these cushions over to the other side, so them lumps are on.
Yeah, on the outside.
Yeah. So if they're on the outside, and then it's just these cushions make up the rest of the bed. Yeah. Yeah, so I just sleep on the underneath as well, just because it's a flat surface, you know, so you're not sleeping on any of
the
this.
Bumpy bits.
So I just literally just flip them over as they are, and then and nobody's getting a bad back in the middle of the night. Yeah, so his stereo is located there.
Oh, right. Okay.
Just it's like an old school stereo, you know, the old face-off ones that you used to
get. Oh, right, yes.
Yep.
And that just comes on. But bear in mind, every time you turn your power on and off, if you leave that like that, as soon as you press the on button on your control panel, if you've got the radio set, it'll start blaring, so I tend to just do that. So every time you turn it on and off, it can... Because it's...
We used to suffer a bit of battery drain in our other van. We always took the front out, because then you...
Yeah, well, with your solar panel now, you should not be experiencing that, I'm sure. It's going to be... Probably above his sink. I'm going to make a liar of me, this one. They put them in different places every time. Is it there? No. There she is.
Right, okay.
So, top light lets us know that we're on.
Yeah.
The bottom light is just letting you know how much it's doing. So flashing, it's doing a very little amount. When they're both constant lights, that's when it's in full power mode. So that's when it's in full operation. But that is like the best pet you've ever had. You won't have to walk it, water it, feed it or anything. If it's got something to do, it'll do it. If it's got nothing to do, it'll just sit there nice and peaceful.
Good.
You don't need to worry about that. It'll just do its job. Right. So, fridge. I'll turn it off to start with. So that's your fridge off now. So to turn it on, press the button. So that means electric. That's gas. Mm-hmm. That's vehicle battery.
So for towing.
Yeah. So
vehicle battery.
Yeah. So like that's kicking off at me now because there's obviously no vehicle battery. So if I put it on gas and it starts flashing, it's because it's failed to light the gas.
Right. Okay.
So all you do, press that button and it will attempt to relight it, and then it just lit. Then did you hear it go pop?
I didn't put it. Yeah. I believe you.
So if it keeps happening.
just get out, make sure you have turned your gas on, but just keep pressing that button and it will purge any air that's in the